So today we're finally going to talk about these rapid round feeders and other open drinkers and ways to keep your bees from drowning. There were some flawed rapid round feeders that caused me to have to put a shim in here with pennies to raise that clear cup above the center cone so the bees could get out there, and look, there's one dead bee right there in the sugar syrup. This time of year, we tend to feed our bees, whether they're packages or a new nucleus colony, bees that need to get a good start. So everyone told me, this is, by the way, not new. It's not something I discovered. Everyone said, hey, Fred, put a sock in it. So that's what we did. We put a sock over the center of the rapid round riser column. Lots of people said to do it. I don't know why I didn't know it before now. But really, I haven't had much of a problem until there was a configuration problem with the rapid rounds, which caused me to look for solutions, and that's what we're doing today. So we have the sock and we have cut pieces of sponge. Put a lot more than this in it. Also, look at that center piece had cracked, and I had to fix it with some super glue. But here's the problem. Look at the standoff from the bottom there, which leaves a space for your bees to get out and get out into that open free surface area of your drinker and drown in the syrup. This is a horizontal long-laying hive that we're using here. And that's because there's a package of bees in there and they need to be taken care of. Why? Because it's going to rain a lot during this time of year. And if we don't provide extra feed at this time of year in spring, one-to-one sugar syrup, then when the rains come, they consume all the resources that they've brought in. And what they're trying to do is build up their brood. So we're going to help them along. But we don't want our bees to drown. So we're going to show a lot of different options here, including what to do when you open feed. And how about when you have an open drinker? Some people put marbles in. We have something else that I'm going to show you. But here it is. The feeder is full to the top. That's the other thing. If you don't have a sock or something in there, fill these all the way to the top. Cuts down on the number of bees that get into the syrup and that end up drowning. But still, maybe one is too many. So the socks satisfy that. Of course, I'm going to show you which socks I decided to use. Some people say, oh, I just put my old socks in there. We're going to use new ones. And these are the Apis rapid round feeders. They're available from several places. These came from Amazon. Link will be in the video description below. They have improved the material quality that they are making these rapid rounds out of, I'm very happy to say. And again, they're just sitting here. We're going to show you some other feeders. Keep these full as much as you possibly can. That results in fewer bees drowning because there's less surface area for them to be pushed off of into the soup. So this is a FlowHive 2 8 frame, which is a 6 frame flow super compatible, and it's got a feeder shim on top. We're going to look inside here, and this is where I've put the sock. Now here's the thing. I let this sock go intentionally over the top of the cone because I'm thinking as it leaches the sugar syrup up in there, the bees are going to feed on the sock syrup rather than going over the top and getting down in the syrup itself. And I can tell you ahead of time, if you don't want to watch this whole thing, the socks work. The other thing is when your bees build up burr comb on the bottoms of these feeders, leave it there. When you wash them out and you sanitize your feeders, don't scrape away this wax because the bees like to climb on it. And look at this. Here we are already. There's a worker and she has her tongue out and she's getting her sugar syrup from the sock. So she's not climbing over the side and she's not in jeopardy of drowning. But of course, we ran this test for a week and we're going to come back and look at them. These are the socks I decided to get. Socks are cheap, man. These socks are 10 boys crew socks. I just cut the ankle parts off and left the foot. Made by Hanes. I'll put a link in the video description for those two. But they're brand new socks. So we want to get all the chemicals out. So I washed them with Dawn dish soap. And then we rinsed them until the water ran clear. And then we dry them out. Why? Because that helps them work better in absorbing the sugar syrup up to the edge. So you can put them over this cone too and not let them drape to the middle. One of the concerns somebody had when they saw that I was going to pull them off through to the middle was that it would leach the syrup out and drip it down inside the hive. I can tell you that did not happen. It stops at the edges of the sock, and the bees come up and they just suck the syrup off the sock itself. And look, no drowning. Not one single bee in any of the sock evaluation feeders got in there and drowned. Of course, there's an artistic shot, sunset. Slow motion sugar syrup on a windy day with the bees coming up and getting at the sugar syrup without drowning. That's the whole point. So in all of the new package installs, we put these feeders in, and now a few days later, we're going to come back and look and see what the results are. Here we go. It's raining. Now, this is the one that had the sock pulled all the way over the center that some had concerns it would just leach all the syrup out and drip it down inside, but that didn't happen. But what's more important is look what the bees did. They only came as far as the sock. They don't try to climb over the top of it. And I want you to look at this wrapped around feeder, which holds a half a gallon. It's drained all the way to the bottom. Now, normally, without the sock there, the bees follow the syrup down to the bottom, and then they end up crawling out underneath the clear cup, and they end up out in the syrup. So with the sock, they don't do that. So as so many people have said, put a sock in it, Fred. So I'm telling you, and if you get a child-sized sock, it fits perfectly. Goes over there, let it go ahead and go right across the middle if you want to. And here we go. We did try the sponges, and the sponges do leach the sugar syrup right up to the top. But just as with the top without the sponges in it, if you let the sugar syrup get down to the bottom, the bees could get out underneath. They can still drown. There is surface area there. So it's safe to say that the sock is better than using bits and pieces of sponge. Although, if you have a ceracell feeder, I highly recommend that you put sock pieces or sponge pieces in those corner fittings so that your bees don't drown. And here's those socks again, pre-washed, ready to go. The only absolutely zero surface area feeder that we have is this new one, Bee Smart Designs 3-Season Feeder. Holds a whole gallon for those of you who want more than the half gallon that the Rapid Rounds offer. So this one definitely will not drown your bees. Now here it is raining today. I wanted to take you out and show you another way that I keep the bees from falling into open drinkers. It is important if you're not giving sugar syrup, you always, always want to have fresh water sources out for your bees. And we go beyond that. We also put out different salt mineral mixes for the bees at 1 teaspoon per quart. So that's just water. And this one has Himalayan pink salt. This one has 1 teaspoon of calcium magnesium. 1 teaspoon Celtic sea salts to the water quart. And then this one seems to be a favorite. 1 teaspoon of calcium magnesium. This is human consumption rated calcium magnesium to pure water. So the most popular out here is the 1 teaspoon Himalayan pink salt. Number 2 is the CalMag. And here, of course, because it's raining, it's actually preventing this colony from swarming out, which they probably really want to do. The problem is the weather is so bad, it's overcast and everything else. We don't want to open it up. But here's what I want to show you. We defeat the free surface area of this larger drinker. Sure, we put bricks in there, but the bees would still fall into the water. This is nothing but fresh water for the bees, and right now, of course, it's full of rainwater. These are Marineland biofilter balls, the same stuff you would use in your fish tanks. So when you put a bunch of them in here, what they do is they actually prevent the direct sunlight from getting through all of the water, so it provides some shade, which cuts down on the algae that grows. And if your bees fall in, they can clamber all over the balls and they don't get stuck. So that's just another bonus. Some people like to put marbles and things like that in their drinkers. I think the bio balls, which are, by the way, very cheap, sitting in there are a much better way to control the bees and let them drink without falling in, and it gives them something to get their footing on so they can climb back out. This, of course, is just a landing board showing that the bees are venting out because it's a nice warm day even though it's rainy, and they're just moving air out of this colony. So I thought you'd probably want to see some bees. Slow motion, of course. And this is a colony of bees that came through winter, so they're doing pretty darn good. We only lost one colony of bees through the winter, I'm very happy to say. And now, within the next couple of days, if the weather will just give us a break, we're going to do a bunch of splits. So here we are back at the drinkers. If you want to see, these are normally entry feeders, but I don't use entry feeders. I do set them out as mineral water sources for the bees. And then we just, on a continuing basis, like to see what they're going for the most. So right now, pink Himalayan salt, 1 teaspoon per quart. And then of course our bio balls, really close. So you can see these bees, just plastic balls that help you get the footing. And like I said, they're dirt cheap. I think it's like $2 or $3 for a whole box of them. So we'll put a link to those. You can put those in bird feeders, anything you want, bird waterers, bird baths, any place where your bees are likely to drown, go ahead and put biofilter bottles in there. And if you need a large capacity, back to the Bee Smart Design 3-season drinker. Fits right over the hole, sits snug, provides some venting. Thanks for watching. Don't drown your bees.